Hello there, lads and ladies, and welcome to Dark Souls 2 once again. So, to start with, I will quickly tell you, basically I recorded Dark Souls 2 a while ago, and the sound did not record. At least my sound did not record. My microphone was switched off. So, I'm going to just be doing a little voiceover and explaining what happens, because this recording went crazy for so many reasons. Right, to start with, you notice I'm going straight down the tunnel, straight to where I should have gone in the last episode. An honor to see you again. This would be the lady, of course, that I was meant to go and speak to last time, but I was a dumbass, and when it said behind the cat's building, I didn't realize down the tunnel for some reason. I didn't think that. Of course, thanks to the comment I got, I realized I should have gone down the tunnel immediately. And yeah, I managed to find her, obviously, and I understood I obviously needed to get 2,000 souls. So, I quickly decided, okay, I'll go to that, the castle place where I found her. Because those guys give like 400 souls or something, and they're relatively easy to kill. And I just, you know, I need to kill a few of them, I'll get a bunch of souls, and I'll have 2,000 souls. I can get through there. At first I'm like running down here, and then I'm like, oh shit, this actually takes a while to get through. So I decide to run back and teleport at Majula. So, yeah, this recording... sorry about my throat. This recording, for so many reasons, that's me checking for a secret that I thought I saw. And, this episode went wrong for many reasons, you will find out, because, this recording goes for about 6 minutes, approximately, and then it will stop quite suddenly, and it will cut forward, because, I'd messed around with the settings on my, computer, and I didn't actually notice the recording stopped, so, there's quite a bit of lost footage, sadly to say. This day was just a bad day, on the general whole, if I just say it like that. So this is me. I'm going to select the top right one as soon as I see it. So I'm going to get 2,000 souls so I can open the passage. So yeah, this recording went very bad for many reasons, but nonetheless, did make some progress. In spite of what will happen later, you will see. Put it this way, I was terrified to spend the entire episode doing one thing. Maybe if you've played through this, maybe you can work out what that thing is. Maybe you can sort of think, what's the thing that maybe took a while through that place for me, maybe, I don't know. Or maybe I'm just a complete noob and it was just me who suffered this, inability to play properly. So yeah, there's me managing to coax an enemy off the edge of the cliff, and I was just like, oh, thanks for 3 souls. Fair dues. And here we go, I need to kill just these guys, and I'll have enough. Of course, it's quite easy to take them down. It's just a bit difficult because I know there's the other guy coming up behind me. But he backs off now. Fighting one-on-one with these guys is pretty easy. Of course, I get a little aggressive here, thinking I can kill him before he attacks. And end up taking a lot of damage. But that's nothing new. I get cocky in this game way too often when I shouldn't get cocky. Frankly speaking, during this episode, a lot of things happened. I'll tell you as each thing happens. Obviously, the first thing that will happen is the loss of footage. There'll be about, I guess about 15 minutes of lost footage. But I did quickly go back and explain what had happened. Of course, during this entire time, all these interruptions and everything, I didn't realize my microphone was off. So that made me think, obviously, I'm gonna do something about that. I don't know. What I would really like is like a light or something on my microphone just to tell me if it's on or off. Just like with like say a webcam, for example. But I'm gonna make a little poster for myself, like a checklist, so I don't forget to check everything before I record. Because it doesn't happen often, frankly speaking. But when it does happen, it's a bit of a shitter, especially when it happens with Dark Souls, because, sadly to say, Dark Souls is the one game that if I lose footage or sound gets lost or whatever, I can't do anything about it. I can't go back and replay through the area.
Just speak up if you're in need, that's why.
I have to move the path. So it goes, hey presto, and it turns around. And I do wonder, like, this is locked off the other passage. Is that a good thing? But I think I've been through that other passage. And I do quickly check what she has to sell for interesting items. What I'm mostly interested in is the spells, of course. The spell I was most interested in of all these spells is the Greater Heal, which I will mouse over in a second. And the one on the far right. Oh yeah, Guidance, that was the one I read. I was like, Guidance, what does that do? It just allows you to see more messages. It's pretty awesome, I guess. But I was expecting something else. Homeward, I was interested in that because I'm not exactly sure how quick to cast Homeward is. And here we go, this is the cut. That would be where the footage stops. So this is me in the next area. I do quickly run back. This is a fella that you meet along the tunnel, because this tunnel basically leads straight from her to here. It's just like this sort of cave. You go through that portcullis, you go along a cave, and then you end up sort of like up here. So yeah, there's me sort of saying down there, that's where I came from. And as you can see, my ring in the top left has changed to the cat ring. So maybe we can work out what, if you've done this, what I've been doing. So I quickly run through, just to sort of say, yeah, this is where I've been. There's some enemies along the way. And this hidden little guy, something hard to notice, but he doesn't really attack you. And the butterfly room. And like I was saying, you just watch out for the poison, but you can easily range them. They die in like one hit, so it's like easy. And the item that falls down, I mentioned, that's poison moss. I did manage to work it out because I didn't know if I could get those items that fell down. So I was like, oh well, they're lost to the void. I do actually manage to get them later on. I find out they're poison moss, which is quite useful. It's a good way to farm poison moss. Of course, that tree down there, that tree shouldn't be down. Obviously, I've progressed enough that I've knocked that tree down. And I was so surprised that I remembered that you could knock trees down, because it's, the last time I did that was in the bloody tutorial, basically. So I'm saying, like, this is where you go. You can attract the attention of the melee mob to drag him outside so you don't have to be shot by an archer. It's easy to take these guys down, but they're quick. They quite often get a blow on you. And there's me trying to lock on to the archer to throw a lightning bolt at him. I do manage to do it, but in the direct sense. I don't have any more charges, so I'm not able to throw the second lightning bolt. So I just decided to carry on. Now, I already know it, because I'm not saying now something like there's a guy behind this door who tries to attack you. And I'm trying to attract his attention, because when I first went through there, I ran up to the door and went to open it, and he freaking battered me a bit. He'd kill me. These guys ain't that deadly. They can get a hit on you, but they ain't deadly. Now you notice my souls are here, right? Now you can see it in the bottom left. This is what I've been trying to get. That's the prize, which I'm having a lot of difficulty getting to. I sort of take a long time to work out how to do this jump properly. And it actually took me a while to find the bonfire, which I'm going to now. I'm sort of saying, like, under this ladder, there's like a little alcove just here, and there's a bonfire, which is quite useful. And I decided to, like, change my spawn, of course. This was a slightly more useful spawn. I was sort of saying, like, you can't jump here, but down there there's a ledge. This is me explaining this, because I found this out when I obviously jumped for the item and I didn't get it. I just sort of landed on the pillar. And it's this route. There's like, just up along this bridge, it's chest. I'm sort of saying, like, there's this fella here you can take out. And there's the fella downstairs running around. Too much to worry about. just waiting for him to move, basically. Yes. And then do your drop attack. Just smash him down in one. We got this chest as well, which had Richard's rapier in it. I remember that item, because I just discussed about it twice. Obviously, the first time I played through when it wasn't before, the second time I mentioned it. And I was sort of saying, it's a good item, but not the sort of item I would use, so I just then go along and carry on along the route. Because you use this to get into sort of a secret area, which you can't otherwise get to. And of course here, there would have been secret doors, like here, sort of thing. You can sort of see the outline of a secret door area. But obviously, having been through it, the secret door has been removed. That's what I mean by these guys often get a hit on you when you attack them. Because they're kind of quick. So, yeah, just cut through all these little guys. Check that out, Kirk, because I didn't actually notice it the first time. And then there's this little fella. Get rid of him. Go back to town. And we head up the ladder at the far end. Because as you can see, this was the area across that sort of edge, basically. But you could get there by just dropping down, I guess. And I get a flame butterfly, and I'm interested in this item, because I'm like, what? What's a flame butterfly sort of thing? I've never had this item before. I notice it there. It's an item to light your torch from anywhere. So I'm like, oh, that's useful. Because being able to actually light your torch anywhere is actually quite useful, because I tend not to run around with a torch. I'm just checking this edge, make sure I can't climb up it, but I can't. I mentioned how I got an item from that body just there. And then I think the slog begins now. The rest of the fire, of course. Get all my health back and Estus and the rest of that jazz. And it's time to try and get that item over there, which I do attempt a multitude of times. And I had attempted to get it quite a few times off camera, of course, which I didn't get recorded. But I guess it's not too bad that footage was lost, really, because it's mostly me just doing this and failing, and then messing up like this. I decided to add 5 additional deaths, by the way, here, because that's probably the amount of times I died trying, or like off camera, about 5 times, I'd say, is probably accurate. So I just decided to add 5, because I couldn't exactly remember. Because I always go back through the recording and count, sort of thing. So I can just sort of zip through in scanning mode and find all the deaths, and then quickly, you know, just add to each one. If I lose the footage, then obviously I can't count back through. So now this becomes a challenge of trying to sort of line up the jump correctly to land in the right place and not roll over the edge like that. Because this jump is all about jumping quite early, actually, and jumping at the right angle. That jump then probably wouldn't have made it even if I did jump at the right angle, because, you know, you would probably just roll over the edge. Even if you landed on the very edge of the platform, you'd probably still roll all the way off the other side. So that's sort of the way this little sort of jump works. It's a nasty little jump. But it pretty much becomes an obsession, because it's an item being dangled around in front of me, and I've already attempted so many times, I may as well keep trying to get it. So I just decided to run through. There's no need to deal with the mobs, you know. Just get to the area I want to get to. Of course, the archer decides to shoot the crap out of me, which kind of angered me a little bit, because when I'd been trying off camera, he'd never shot me a single time. That's what I want to do there. And of course, the tree being down means I can just run around this way, opposed to going the upper way. Also, that's also why this episode got branded the Jumping Episode. Why I decided to pick that name for it. because I decided just simply to name it that because I was jumping so much. Obviously, I've been lining up to try and do another jump, but I'm sort of trying to judge the angle. That's actually where I spaz out and completely jump in the wrong direction, but I sort of go, hang on. Maybe I can jump from here onto there, and I accidentally do a roll instead of a jump. But I'm pretty sure even if I did do that method, it doesn't really work. This is where I realize, oh, this guy followed me. But, you know, I just go aggressive on him, and he goes down nice and easy. So sword's nice and powerful. Oh, I might want to add, actually, I did mention at the start of the recording that I noticed I had something called the Ultra Greatsword. It's basically the same as the sword I have, but it does slightly more damage. However, I was looking at the stat modifiers, and I think this weapon has a C for dexterity and a C for strength, like for added bonus. And the Ultra Greatsword, I think, has a C for strength, so the same, but like an E or a D or something for dexterity, so I was kind of maybe off-put a bit by that sort of thing. But I'm still going to get my strength up and test out the Ultra Greatsword, because the Ultra Greatsword does more base damage, but it has a slightly higher strength requirement in order to use it. This is where I actually realized I'd picked up an item in a box called a Monastery Token, I think it was called. And I was thinking, a Monastery Token, what is that? I checked my items first of all, and I'm like, what's this, what's that? I don't manage to find it here. So I think maybe it's like a Monastery Token, maybe it's like a Miracles item. So I go to my caster stuff, and I'm like, no, actually it ain't here. Then I just check a few other things, like, you know, maybe it's a ring. I can't see any new rings, so, you know. I check my keys, like maybe a monastery token, maybe it's a key. It's probably not one of these, I was thinking, sort of thing. A spell? I was kind of thinking maybe a monastery token, some sort of spell or something. At the end of the day, I just couldn't find the item. Sure what a monastery token is. I'm pretty sure it's called a monastery token. Don't quote me on that. I'm not 100% sure, because that's what I was thinking then, but obviously between then and the time I actually read what the item was, that could be very different things. My brain is like Chinese whispers. So, next the corpse disappears, and then I attempt to do the jump again, but I completely mess it up and do a roll. So it was like a waste of time going all the way around, I felt. Problem is I want to hold on to the souls, of course, that I've got. So I've got 5,000 souls, I don't want to just waste them. So we just try again. And this is, what, like the first god knows how long this episode is. Just doing this stupid same jump. Because I'm just, you know, I see the item in front of me, I've got to get it. Can't just not get this item. You can't ignore it at all. Because it might be something really, really good. That guy just jumps off and I'm like, thanks. This guy's an easy one. He didn't die, I know. He fell on the tree. Survived. I was just wondering if he's going to help the item. And he stops. He doesn't progress that far. So I decided, okay, let's get a run up and go for it. And I get onto this part now. Okay, let's go across a bit. Oh no, actually, no, I decided to go under here. Okay, I don't remember doing this. Yeah, I tried jumping from here. I was like, gonna run. Oh no. I just tried to roll it. Well, that clearly wasn't gonna work. What was I thinking? What a bloody idiot. yes, this day was my complete imbecile day. A lot of things that didn't go quite right. This guy decided to make himself a problem, so I decided to remove him from the equation. And pick the nice souls in the process. So, yeah. Carry on back. and it's just time to keep jumping. Jump, jump, jump. Jump, 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 jump. So yeah, I'm kind of wondering if you guys had as much trouble as I did with this jump, because I just couldn't work this jump out for whatever reason. I just had trouble with it. For some reason, I just didn't want to, you know, get it right. And that's where it clips like my toe or something, that bloody arrow. I'm amazed he even hit me. And that's the bit where I almost slipped right off the side. I would have probably been fine since I got the cat ring on. It's time for another attempt. Don't worry, sooner or later we will stop doing run arounds because I will accidentally lose my souls, which makes me start doing it much quicker. And like, I'm thinking, wow, I stopped so quick when I landed then, why can't I do that on the actual pillar? Like, just an instant stop. No roll or anything. So I just had to run and jump it, but wrong angle. But it was a good idea. That was a good attempt, in my mind. So like, if I'd done that at the right angle, I might have landed on it. But, you know. You need to kind of land on that pillar in a diagonal. Because the side-to-side is such a small area, you might not be able to just land there and be fine. So it's like, you know, going up. There you are again, sticking you out. It's time for another attempt at a jump. I do this, and here I'm like, okay, what should I do? I decided to try this again. Because also I can get my souls, so I'm like, okay, run around, and then I just run straight to the side. I'm like, bloody hell. I just decided to jump off the side, because I couldn't be asked to run all the way around. I just sort of decided, screw this, I ain't running through that catacomb again. I'm just going to jump off the side and hope my soul's in a decent location. Of course, that was kind of the mistake. Because I think this is probably the jump where I lose my souls. So let's have a look. Because it's pretty much inevitable. Because my souls are now on the platform, which means I have to land on the lower platform to get my souls. Which is probably too much of an ask for me. So I land here, and I'm like, okay, let's try jumping from here, and off we go. Because you can't really run on that slope. That slope is not really walkable terrain, because it's very, very vertical. So you very much just fall off. So now it's like the case, okay, I've lost the souls, so it doesn't matter, I can just keep jumping off, and if I don't make it, I can just jump off the side and try again. Take out this fella, grab our souls, and try again. That jump was just terrible, and I was like, okay, I landed in the worst spot, let's just jump off, try it again. Because that's sort of what this becomes, is just basically an obsession. I just need that item. I was just like sort of saying like, oh, I've come this far. I've tried so many times. If I don't get this item, I'm just going to constantly be thinking about it. Like, what was that item? What was that item? Sort of thing. So I just need to get it to find out. But I'm also telling myself, I bet it's going to be a really crappy item. I bet it's really not going to be something that's worth it. What's that? We'll find out later. I already know, of course, what it is. There's me jumping way too early. Because, I sort of double-tapped the button by accident. Because I sort of took my finger off the button. I was like, oh, okay, stop. And I was like, you know, actually, no, keep running. But obviously tapping the button again makes you jump. So it's a mistake. But I do that mistake from time to time. Then I sort of hold down the run button intending to jump, and then I change my mind about the jump, and then I decide, oh no, I've got to go for the jump because I'm already running. I double tap the button, which makes me just jump at a stupid moment. I think this might be the point where, oh no, the guy is still there. I'm like watching him like hover off the edge of the terrain. it's time to go for another attempt and jump. And I'm like, oh, that was so good. But I got flipped off the edge. So I sort of came up with the idea that that was a really good jump. I did the diagonal and everything, but I need to jump sooner. I need to be, like, in the air sooner so I land much earlier. So this is the plan from this point, is to sort of jump sooner, land earlier, so I can make that jump. I said the word jump ridiculous amount of times. So I'm still here, I thought you'd be gone by now. I've killed him so many times between spawns. So I'm like there, I do the jump again, it's more or less the same sort of thing. I'm like, okay, you know, this would be easier if I didn't have to wait so long between jumps. Because that's one of the affecting factors, really, is you can't just do this jump, 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 jump like that. You can't just attempt it over and over again and sort of gauge the last one and change what you did for the next one. Because you have to do this whole process of respawning and everything and then coming back around, doing the jump again. And the time it takes to practice the jump is long enough that you sort of forget what you did last time. You're like, you forget, like, the muscle movement. By this point, I'm just like, screw it. May as well keep trying, because you may as well get the item, because it's there. You can just keep trying at the end of the day. It's not great for my whole death counter, but it's better to have the item and not think about it, or think how crap it was. Than to not have it and always think, oh, what was that item? I want that item. So I do an absolutely terrible jump. But I was saying to myself, I jumped early enough, just a completely wrong angle. So we at least know the angle of which to jump for next time. So I'm ready for it this time. I'm like, okay, I know when to jump. I know how early I sort of need to do it. I know the angle I need to do it. I just need to do these things at the same time. If I can get that done, I've got the item in the bag. I retrieve my thing, even though it's 0 souls. I do the angle slightly wrong again. Maybe a bit late as well. But it was a good try. You just need to angle it better and probably jump a bit earlier. Sort of like the conclusion, because I'm sort of like getting to this point where, okay, I need to jump slightly earlier, I need to jump more at this angle or something. So go back around for another attempt. It's just a simple case of we can't stop. We've come this far. And then, perfect. It's Ferrous Lockstone and a token of fidelity. And I'm like, okay, Ferrous Lockstone, cool, but what's the token of fidelity? Look for it. I'm like, hang on, where is it? And I'm kind of looking for the new-ish item, and I'm like, it's that one. And I'm like, okay, it's a multiplayer item. So I'm just like, okay, that's not great. So I wasn't particularly impressed with that item. And the Ferrous Lockstone, I decided, it could potentially be an awesome item, but the problem is with Ferrous Lockstones is they can also be completely useless if you're unlucky. Because I was sort of thinking of the rat area, sort of, if you remember, I used like a whole bunch of Ferrous Lockstones and they didn't really do anything. I'm not sure what to think about that area. Because I'm thinking, every time I've used a Ferrous Lockstone up until the rat area, I've always got like some really good loot or something. And I'm thinking the rat area probably does have some sort of really super loot. To get it, that's the thing. So I take out the butterflies, so I don't have to worry about poison. And I'm looking for obviously the fella who's down below. Because drop attacking him is like a really easy way to just, you know, just kill. I got some poison moss. I look for the other one, but I'm like, oh no, it's up on the cliff, I can't reach that. So now we can actually leave the jump. So finally I'm going to actually make some real progress. This obsession is now gone. so now we can just cut our way through really quick and head towards the forest, actually. Sort of little foresty area. I try to sneak up on that guy. These guys just can't be stuck up there for whatever reason. I've actually just noticed, back when I was doing this area, I didn't notice my health was so low. I'm now thinking back to myself, why didn't I, like, you know, pop my humanity, pop an Estus flask, all the rest of that stuff. This is where I realise, hang on, my health is incredibly low. So obviously I'll heal myself up back to maximum because, you know, you need to pop your humanity from time to time. When your health gets really, really low, especially with a character like mine, my character does not have HP, does not have physical defenses really. My character is all aggressive, all about dodge. It's all about not being hit at all. It's not about taking hits, it's about not being hit whatsoever. So I decided to carry on because I'm like, okay. Can't be asked to get an extra Estus, so probably won't need it. Just cutting through an area like this, if it's too hard. And it's the fellas up on a cliff, but obviously I could start kindly. I want to deal with him first. And then I'm like running for the site, and then I just sort of notice the stick move, like right as I walk past him. Get some items. I'm like, fair enough. Some just standard easy items, you know, souls and blah. So now it's time to cross the bridge and see what we see. And I'm like, oh, hello there, big guy. How's it going? He runs at me like that, and I'm like, okie dokie, I'll just back off now. Of course, that big guy doesn't seem to be able to run forever. Careful, because I'm like realizing, hang on, I gotta be careful here, there's no terrain behind me. I'll take some hits from him, but it's okay, all in all. Could have been much worse. This is where I think, oh, I could go back and get my Estus restored, and I'm like, actually, no, I don't want to respawn that big guy. Because I haven't sort of learned how to deal with them. That's the thing with most enemies, it's a case of learning, how do I deal with this enemy? Of course, we see the butterfly ahead up on the tree, and I'm like, okay, script some arrows. We can deal with them with range weapons. Damage spells, but we can still range. It's just an easy one shot. I'm thinking, there's one over there, but it's down a cliff. I don't wanna dedicate myself down a cliff because I ain't gonna be able to climb back. And it's this little prison. I'm thinking, hang on, there's a way out there, but I can't break in here. Is there any other way out? I'm like, okay, there's a cliff over the top. Probably drop down. And I'm like, yeah, that's probably the way out after you drop into it and get the loot. Use that little tunnel to get out. So, alright, that's easy enough. You can get in there. Just run up the cliff a little bit. And that's all these fellas sort of like waiting for us. So we go and take them out first. Put some attacking like a noob and get attacking back while I'm not looking. Because these guys ain't that easy to notice, really. There's the archer across there shooting at us. And instead pop Nestus. And just go for it. Use the good old sprint attack. Just wham him down. I really like the sprint attack. It's pretty nifty. So I'm like, okay, here's the loot. But at that moment, there's a cut you saw there. That cut was basically me going down the shop to get a tin of tomatoes because we were having spaghetti bolognese and it started cooking, but forgot the tomatoes. So while they were tending the food, they asked me to run down the shop, get the tomatoes and come back sort of thing. So I literally very quickly got jogs down there and got it. And forgot to open my windows while I was out of my room. So by the time I came back, which was like after, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes, my room was incredibly hot, I remember. It was really, really hot in my room, and I was like, oh, I'm sweating. So hot in here. So I like come back up here, and I'm thinking, okay, we've got to get over there, clearly we've got to lower this bridge. Which will have a switch somewhere. And it's these little huts, I'm like, okay. Oh, there's the switch. That's how you lower the bridge. There's an opening here, easy enough. Oh, okay, hello there. Drops in and just gets owned. It's close range like that. If he's going to drop in, I can take him out. So I lower the bridge and I'm like, okay. Well, that's lower in. Let's go check the rest of this place out. Because I noticed there was a lot of items starting around. Places to go in this place, so I should make use of that. I should just, you know, ignore the stuff. Of course, I noticed this little room, and I'm like, okay, there's been waiting somewhere. Let's have a look. That's some of the iron bars. Let me find the actual way in. I'm like, okay, let's wait a moment. Something. No guy drops in. I'm like, fair enough. I was kind of expecting the same trap that happened before. Since there was a hole above it, but it didn't happen, so. Whatevs. I've just noticed actually, which I didn't notice while I was playing, it's like a big rope bridge leading to like a castle or something above me. I've just noticed that. I didn't notice that when I was playing before. I'm trying and failing to hit this guy. Give us a life gem. That's the big fella. Alright, okay. Can sneak up on this fella. Shoot two eyes. Of course, he notices me, so that didn't work out quite as planned. But I decided, hang on, I can just sort of kite him around this tree. See what we can do with this. Now I'm trying to sort of get around him. Or try to lure him into attacking, and then, like, you know, get behind. Okay, these guys are pretty slow actually. I pick up the poison moss because I did notice it in the tree. And I was like, oh, well, what's that from? And I was like, oh yeah, the butterfly that I killed obviously. And I was like, hang on, I can sneak up on this guy. Easy stuff. This is me. So I'm like, hang on, I'm not as stealthy as I thought I was. Back off, deal, and that sort of stuff. Let's lure him into attacking. Using these trees as a bit of a blockade. Alright, okay. Backstab time. And I work out that that's the easy way to take these guys out. It's just lure them into attacking, get behind them, take them out. Then they go down. Quickly check this, because I'm like, can I go in this one? I'm like, yeah, probably. In it. Of course, now we can get to the last side of the area. Aromatic ooze. Remember saying that lovely smelling ooze? So undeads don't smell quite as bad. That's why they have it. So that's time to cross the bridge and head along. But now I've noticed it actually. I didn't notice while I was playing, but there was like a rope bridge leading to some place. It's like sort of to my right now. I never noticed it before. I'll check that out next time I play. But, for the time being, I need to go from this place. Of course, we find the locked door here, and I'm like, okay, what's in there? It's like a bonfire, that's cool. Is there a way up over the top? Guess not. Can't see nothing. Checking the cave to see if it sort of turns in. Just trying to get up it, just in case. Get out the fire to make sure there isn't any sort of like traps or anything, or any secret switches. I'm like, okay, is that fire like keeping whatever's in this dark cave? Is there gonna be like those things that are scared of fire? And then I notice the sound, the body. Yeah, it's a skeleton. Just taking it out nice and smooth. But I notice instantly I don't get any souls, so I'm like, okay, I see. There's a necromancer. because if you don't get the souls, then the necromancer battle. So the orb is hot. I don't know, this is some sort of problem. Take out the skeleton, take some damage in the process, which isn't great. But it's fine, I guess. I'm like, okay, we need to locate a necromancer, we need to do that quick. I decided to go a bit aggressive on that guy, but that's because, you know, I was like, okay, let's get rid of this guy quick. There's an archer ahead, I'm like, oh shit, there's a guy behind me and everything. But I'm like, oh shit, there's the necromancer. It's just like, okay, just take out the necromancer, that's our job, just get him. Luckily, we managed to get the necromancer, so, you know, we got him at least, so the skeletons won't spawn. Because that's an important thing. And of course, I was sort of thinking, I hope that mechanic's still in place. I hope it isn't, like, changed mechanic, sort of thing. Like, they could change the mechanic so the necromancers would respawn. And then it's just a case that you always need to kill the necromancers, then the skeletons. Like, it's always the situation. But we do work out that it, no, it isn't like that. That's me failing to hit this guy and allowing him to just very easily hit me. I decided to, like, clear out the area. I don't want anything sneaking up behind me. Because that's kind of the worst thing. Like, enemies just get behind you, it always causes problems. This is me checking my armor, because earlier I picked up, like, rogue gauntlets. I was thinking, hang on, are they better than my gauntlets? So I have a little look around for them. I'm like, oh, there they are. I'm like, oh, they're lighter, that's nice, but they give you a lot less of every stat. I'm like, looking at the brigand gauntlets. And they're lighter, but they give you slightly more in some of the stats. I decided just to stick with my armor for the time being and carry on. So that's this big guy, I'm like, let's just go for him quick. And it works. Works great. Sneaking up on him slowly doesn't seem to work, but just going for it quickly, since they're so slow, seems to look pretty fine. Of course, I forget about the butterfly, it instantly get poisoned. Quickly rush through my items. Get the bow. Take out that fella. I can hear, like, the chains rattling around. I'm just like, oh crap. Big fella's next. So this is the same sort of tactic. You sort of sneak up behind him, and he's down. I've gone for good, easy mode. This area with the bandits. Okay, let's get rid of these guys. Get rid of the archer, nice and easy. But I'm like, hang on, I didn't kill him in one. So I took a whole bunch of damage from that gear. Right, okay, let's heal up. And I'm like, whoops, poison moss, wrong thing. So now I go for the archer. The archer nails me straight in the head. I back off instantly like shit. He just keeps hitting me sort of thing. Alright, okay, let's heal up. And let's go for it. No, it's not taking any chances. Gonna make sure he's down. So we're once again in this sort of area. Where these sort of cliffs and catacombs are. I'm like checking the door again, make sure I didn't miss anything I didn't notice before. I did miss something before, I just noticed the guy then. I didn't notice him before, I remember that. I noticed him just then, I was like, oh, hey guy, how about you let me in, sort of thing. But it's like a prison, he's locked in there. So this was like the moment of truth, this was like, okay, is the necromancer gonna make him respawn, or are they dead and gone? Sort of thing. So I like, take out the skeleton, I'm like, oh yes, I got souls, that means he's not coming back. Take out that stupid jar, doesn't cause any problems. instantly greeted at the corner. Guy left himself wide open. I'm like, there's my souls. I'm so close. I need to get those. Just need this archer to deal with. And then run around and do a quick attack. Chases after me, and I just take him out when I pull him away from the jar. That guy didn't expect to like do that last attack, but still dodged it anyway. I'm like, okay, get rid of the jar, boss. There we go, 5,000 extra souls. I'm like checking down here, like, oh cool, what's this area then? Okay, it's like a locked door. I can see a lever on the other side. There's nothing on this side. And I'm like, the only thing on this side is this little torch. There isn't anything else here. Maybe I need to light the torch in order to open this sort of thing. Like, you know, I don't see anything else. It's only this torch. That's the only thing here. So I'm like, okay, let's make use of these fire butterflies since I got them. It takes me a while to see it. Now I can see it straight away. Back then I was like, where the heck is it? There we go. Light this torch. I go out of the menu. I like that. I'm like, okay, it's gonna open, and nothing. I was like, okay, that was wishful thinking. Clearly, I need to just get around to the other side, and it's just like a shortcut. But I'm like, okay, since I did this already, I need to light all these little sconces. I'm like trying to decide, should I keep the torch going to light more like lights along the way, or should I get rid of it? And we more or less arrive here, which is outside, and I sort of decide, okay, maybe we need to get rid of it, sort of thing. Because I'm outside now, I don't think I'm going to find any light things out here. Looks like enemies from all angles, I start getting shot and everything. I'm like, hang on, where should I go? I finally decided to actually put it away. I'm like, no, it's that guy. I'm like, okay, let's get him. Rush and smash, and I'm like, oh shit, there's a guy behind. I managed to deal with him, we'll be fine. Healing up, most important. Got ourselves a rogue hood. And an undead lockaway key, and I'm like, instantly like, oh yes, that is definitely the key to that door. So, run back there. This is a bonfire there, and a bonfire would be useful. I'm a bit low on all Lester's flasks. So it's time to run back. Make use of this undead locker key. Get ourselves a new sort of respawn point, a new teleport point. Speak with this fella, see what he has to say.
For a moment. You've set me free. Now I can find him. The cheeky prick. He won't know what hit him.
And instantly at this point I'm thinking, does he mean that guy? The one who like locks the door behind me sort of thing. Because he was a bit of a cheeky prick by definition.
I've heard this land was full of danger. Thought it would suit me perfectly. I joined forces with a man on the way, but he was no more than a backstabbing knave.
By this point I was like, okay, that was definitely him. This is the warrior that he locked away.
I decided to set a trap for him here. But then I got trapped myself. I can't believe that I was so dense. Thank the stars that you came along. You be careful of him. Pate, I think he said. He wears this rather unusual ring. You'll know it when you see it. I've seen his type before. He kills entirely for the pleasure of it. I'm sure I won't be his last victim. The man's better off dead. I tell ya. He's a slick talker. So don't let him fool you.
By this point, I'm like, yeah, we know who this is.
And don't you believe a bed and put an end to his roguery.
Oh, sweet. I learned a gesture. Fist bump.
Pite. The man with a strange ring.
Alright, okay. It's going to like say the same sort of thing over and over now. I've got the gesture, now it's time to move along this place. Okay, let's take the outer route this time. No need to go really through the cave. We know it sort of links up ahead, just a bridge. So I may as well check through this area. Start using the heavy blows occasionally, just to make sure these guys die. Well, of course, they're very sneaky, these guys. They often get a hit on you, even when you hit them. They're very quick, you need to be aware of that. I'm like, oh, okay, we're definitely here now. This is that up bit. Let's check this out then. So now, like, you know, we've neutralized a couple of points. I'm like, okay, there's an item there. Sweet, let's go get it. And I'm like, oh shit, there's a crystal bug here. I tried to lock onto the crystal bug, and it instantly locks onto this guy beside me. So I'm like, oh crap, the crystal bug's way, well and truly got away now. But I didn't even see those guys. All I saw was the item. I didn't see the crystal bug, I didn't see these guys at the start. Let's take one spell, I know it's easy. Pick up a flame butterfly. And some poison knives. I'm like, okay, where did it go? Let's have a look. And I'm like, okay, it's like an interesting jump there. Maybe I can make that. Oh, no, it's the science to my right. Okay, I guess I get that later on. There's no way I'm crossing a bridge that's down. So I jump through this little thing and can't quite make it. But I should take out that fella. And then I notice dark spirits invading from along there. And I'm like, oh, how am I going to deal with this? I can't fight on this edge. It's too small to fight here. Maybe I can use ranged attacks? No, there's just not enough space. We need to find somewhere else to fight. So I lure into this room, throw a lightning bolt, give it a good old bolt. Make sure not to get hit. Going for the offensive. I'm saying, oh, this little tiny room doesn't really fit for fighting. Also, my health's low. If I get hit, I might go down. So we heal up, go back in, take a little hit. Ain't too bad though. And we go on the offensive. She gets me again, and then backs off. But I'm like, okay, yeah, you can turn your back to me, and I'll just assassinate you, sort of thing. So I'm like, oh shit, sword's at risk. So I'm like, okay, it's fine, we got rid of this soul. I'm like, yeah, I can't be asked to use repair powder, we'll just swap to the hellbird, go with that for a bit. So now we carry along the road with our 10,000 souls, which I'm like quite happy with now. I'm like, oh sweet, built up some souls now, that's nice. We spend all the levels up soon. I'm like, okay, what's this area? I'm like, smoke in there, okay, maybe there's a boss ahead. Then I get here and I'm like, okay, there's definitely a boss in there, but I want to go this route first, because I want to get the loot before the boss. I'm like, okay, we've got skeletons and stuff. What am I going to do in here? Because at first I was thinking, have I been here before? Because it's all lit up. And I'm like, okay, maybe I haven't. It's just lit up anyway. Take out that fella. Okay, I need to heal up. I'm a bit low. But I obviously don't have any healing items really equipped. So take out that little fella. And I'm like, okay, right, I need to heal up. I can't go in like this, I've got no HP. If I get taken out, it's gonna suck because I need to get that necromancer. So I'm like, okay, well, let's put the life gems. Use what we need. Let's sort of wait, you know, check in the skeletons, don't come back to life, you know, let my health get up to what it's going to get up to, and I'm like, okay, shit, he's over there. And I go to sprint it, but as you can see, I completely mess up. The intention was to, like, sprint, jump across to him, like, on his little platform and fight him there. But, like, I just instantly sort of tapped the sort of sprint key, like, multiple times, and just end up completely boning it up. This is where I was like, okay, let's cross the bridge, let's go back to that. I'm like, oh shit, wrong bridge. This bridge. This guy's coming for me. I'm like, okay, you just come run to your death. I wonder if those boulders can be very suspect. Okay, let's take it easy. I've got 10,000 souls at risk here. Let's not go losing them to anything stupid. Let's take this easy. Let's get through. Okay, let's get this archer fucker. Got him. Nicely. I'm like, okay, I've got another chance to get that crystal plug. Should we do it? Or should we just go? Alright, yeah. Can't just ignore it. Crystal bug could be potentially extremely useful. I think, how can I get this bugger? Just run for him? Just run for him. And I accidentally tapped this freaking sprint key instead of the attack key, just like not thinking or something. And yeah, this results in me just jumping on the bug opposed to attacking it. Okay, next time we won't jump on it, we'll actually attack it. For the time being, we need to get back down here. I'm like, oh, hang on, there's like a little ledge here. Well, I didn't notice this before. Drop down, grab ourselves some poison moss, and all right, that works. I'm thinking, hang on, this edge is a bit close. We can actually land safely, it's fine, I'm happy. Getting out of the way of the passage so I don't get shot by some archer. Bringing out the meteor, bringing him down. Getting shot in the side, which kind of makes me panic for a moment because I'm like, oh shit, I'm attracting like more attention than I expected. Alright, okay, let's take out this guy. So remove him from the equation so I'm not being shot on the outside of here while I try to deal with this guy. Trying to lock on, it doesn't work, but I just go for the sprint attack and that works out perfectly fine. Taking a hit along the way though, because archers are a little bit of a pain. They're good at leading their shots. So now we start heading back into the skeleton infested hole. Okay, there's my souls. I'd like to get those. Should I go for them, or is it too much of a risk? Okay, let's try to attract some skeletons. Oh shit. You didn't keep running. Take him out like that. I'm like, okay, get out of the way. The archer's shooting at me. Guy comes along with his shield. Take him out nice and easy. I'm like, okay, archer's left. Don't want these guys respawning around me. That'll be a bit of a pain. He draws his sword and I'm thinking, okay, he's coming for me, I'll get him. And I'm like, oh crap, okay, we got respawns going on here. And I'm like kind of thinking, look at this guy and going, he's acting really strange, like he's not really attacking me. And then when I go for the attack, he counters me like that, and I'm like, oh shit. And so I run out of there instantly. But I didn't even know they could counter. I back off and heal. I'm like, okay, it's just not giving a chance. Get rid of those two guys, they're like dead, they're miles away from the necromancer, they're gonna be behind me now. I'm like, okay, he's just swapped weapon, he doesn't have a chance to counter, and it's just annihilating him before he has a chance. Okay, let's get out of here, let's get that necromancer, we need to get him quick. Right, okay, grab souls, at least those are safe. Okay, little magic man, roll out the way, lightning bolt time. For the next shot, roll out the way, and another lightning bolt. should seal the deal. Okay, there's no items over there, so I don't need to worry about jumping. Let's carry on our way. Like, oh, sweet, I'm here. I'm like, combustion, Titanite shard, nice. It's a pyromancer spell, but, you know, I'm not interested in pyromancy now. Oh, okay, there's a light ahead. Where's this? Oh, there's the portcullis. I know where I am. This is just behind that sort of, you know, where I lit the light. Go find three flame butterflies. Oh, sweet. Those flame butterflies will be handy. Open up the passage, so we have our shortcut. But at this point, I'm like, okay, an hour's gone by. I need to finish the recording, really. I'm like, okay, we're going to take on the boss next time. For the time being, we're just going to head back out of here. So we've got skeletons coming for us. I'm like, okay, here he comes. And he does that, and I'm like, okay, he's going to counter me. Because, like, when they run up to you like that, really, really suspect, don't attack. It means they're just going for the counter. I'm like, okay, this guy's a little counter bastard. I'm like, oh, he pulled out his bow. Okay, easy stuff. So you have to watch out for the ones that have bows. That's what I'm thinking. Like, the ones that have bows also can counter you when they go into, like, you know, melee combat. So you need to be careful dealing with them. Ooh, an alluring skull. Sweet. Can't remember what alluring skulls do exactly, but I'm like, at this point, like, okay, just pass this last guy. Just run straight to the old bonfire, have a little rest. And then we can call it here. So, okay, guys, I will say this. I'm sorry for the voice stuff being lost. It's kind of my own fault. Of course, this will be going to spend a level up, but I'll let that just happen in the background. Yeah, I lost the footage, which is a big pain in the ass. I didn't really want that to happen, of course. But I hope you're okay with this little voiceover. Of course, bear in mind, any advice that you do give me always affects not the episode after, but the episode after that. So, you know, I apologise for that, because it must be quite aggravating when I do such stupid things sometimes in the episode after you, like, leave such a useful comment. yeah. But it generally does kick in the following episode after that. So there's me just checking out the Ultra Great Sword that I was, like, sort of, you know, I was discussing from time to time during this episode. Anyway, guys, hope you have a wonderful day, as per usual, whatever you're up to. Next time, the recording will be fine. And we'll make sure to check everything so I don't bone it up like I did this time. So until then, guys, have a wonderful day, as per usual, whatever you're up to. And I'll see you next time. So until then, good day and goodbye. Have a wonderful day, whatever you're up to.